गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन ऑफ क्लास 9th. नाउ द न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन. इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियोज आई हैव एक्सप्लेन अबाउट न्यूटन्स फर्स्ट लॉ एंड सेकेंड लॉ. चिल्ड्रन, न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन इज टू एवरी एक्शन देयर इज ऑलवेज एन इक्वल एंड अपोजिट रिएक्शन. नाउ यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड फ्रॉम दिस एग्जाम्पल एज वी कैन से दैट द we are having two force of action and the force of reaction. Now see this example, see this figure. When a book is placed on a tabletop, the book exerts a force equal to its weight. See from this figure, this in the downward direction, and the table also balances it by an equal force but in the opposite direction, that is the reaction. So this action and reaction, that is called the Newton's third law of motion. Now another example you can understand. Suppose when you are pushing a wall, when you exert a force, that is the force of action on the wall, and the by pushing the palm of your hand against it, now you will also experience a force. That is the force of reaction exerted by the wall on your palm. So that is Newton's third law of motion, that is to every action there is an equal and opposite reaction. Children, you can see this, the motion of rocket motion also. See this figure, action and reaction in rocket motion also. In a rocket, fuel is burnt inside. This I think this we all know, the rocket and the burnt gases at high pressure and high temperature are expelled out of the rocket through a nozzle. See this figure, this is a nozzle. Thus rocket exerts a force F, action on the gases. You can see from this figure, force on gases, that is action on gases to expel them through a nozzle backward. The outgoing gases, these outgoing gases, they will exert a pressure, an equal and opposite force. Equal and opposite force, that is C, force on rocket reaction, that is reaction force. These gases will exert a reaction force, or you can say, or force R, see here, on the rocket, due to which it moves in the forward direction. By which law? By Newton's third law of motion. Now children, all these questions, now see exercise 3D. These questions, children, you have to do. Question number 2, question number 4, question number 5, question number 6, question number 7, 8, 9, 10. These till 10 questions, these questions you have to do it in your physics register. Now come to the new topic, that is universal law of gravitation. Now children, listen my explanation. Each mass particle of the universe attracts other mass particle. The force of attraction between two particles because of their masses is called the gravitational force of attraction. So our scientist Sir Isaac Newton gave a new law that is known as Newton's law of gravitation. Now what is this Newton's law of gravitation? Means according to Newton, the force of attraction, this law states that the force of attraction acting between two particles is directly proportional to the product of their mass. See, from here you can see F means force is directly proportional to the product of the mass. Suppose two bodies are there, M1 and M2. So it is directly proportional to M1 and M2. Second one, it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. See this figure again, you see two particles are there, M1 and M2, they are separated with a distance r. So inversely proportional to the square of the distance. See, F is inversely proportional to 1 upon r square. Now if you join both these equations, you will get f is equal to g m1 m2 upon r square. And what is this g? Where g is the constant of proportionality and is known as universal gravitational constant. Now when you find what the formula of g, so g is equal to fr square. From here only you can find, see, cross multiplication, fr square upon m1 and the SI unit you can take out from here, children, where unit of force is Newton, R is the distance, that is meter square, and M1 and M2, they are the masses, that is kg square. So the SI unit is Newton meter square per kg square. And this value of G is given by our scientist. This is 6.67 into 10 ki power minus 11 Newton meter square plus upon kg square. Children, this you have to learn. And this G is called gravitational constant. What is this gravitational constant? Listen it. It is numerically equal to the magnitude of the force of attraction between two masses each of 1 kg placed at a separation of f meter. Now here some important points are there, ki this gravitational force is always attractive. This gravitational, see, m1 and m2, two masses, see, they are attracted towards each other. Secondly, it is directly proportional to the product of the masses. Thirdly, it is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them. See, you can see here from this figure. Fourth point, this universal gravitational force is significant between heavenly bodies but is insignificant between ordinary bodies. Why? Because a small magnitude of G. Now children, the question come over here, ki if our scientist Sir Isaac Newton has given the three laws, first law, second law and third law, then why this universal law of gravitation our scientist has given? What is the importance of this law? See, the importance of this law is that to explain the motion of planets around the sun, the motion of the moon around the earth, and the motion of a freely falling body. This is the importance of the law of gravitation. Now coming to the next topic, that is the force due to gravity. This I think in previous chapter 2 I have explained the force with which the earth attracts a body towards its center. We always say that earth attracts a body towards its center is called the force due to gravity. Now if we consider a mass of a body small m and mass of the earth capital M and radius of the earth capital R, so what is the force of attraction? From this formula, just now we have done this formula, F is equal to G M1 M2 upon R square. From this formula only you can give F is equal to G, capital M is the mass of the earth, small m is the mass of the body, upon R is the distance between the two bodies. So now if you put the value means M is the mass of the earth, mass of the earth is given this much, radius of the earth is given this, and if mass of a body is, if we have taken 1 kg mass, then you put the value, then it will come 9.8 Newton. What does it mean? It means that earth attracts a body of mass 1 kg by a force of 9.8 Newton towards its center. Now children, coming to the acceleration due to gravity, this small g, in second chapter I think I have explained what is acceleration due to gravity, and it is denoted by small g, and I think its value is 9.8 meter per second square, and its SI unit is meter per second square. Now what is the relation between small g and capital G? Small g is acceleration due to gravity and capital G is gravitational constants. Now again you see, let small g be the acceleration due to gravity. So by Newton's law of motion, the second law of motion, we know F is equal to m into a. Here we will take g. Why? Because we are taking gravity. by Newton's gravitational law. Just now we have done this. Now from first and two, both the equation, equalize both the equation. So this m will cancel, m and m cancel. So what will the value will come? G is equal to g m upon r square. This is the relation between small g, between small g and capital G. Now the value of G, so what you can say? You can say the value of small g on a planet depends on the mass and the radius of that planet. Now here the next part is, what is mass and what is weight? What is the difference between the mass and the weight? In earlier classes, children, we have done, what is the difference between mass and weight? What is mass? Mass is the quantity of matter contained in it. And SI unit, at a SI unit is kilogram, and CGS unit, you all know it is gram. And how it is measured? It is measured by physical balance or beam balance. Now coming to that, what is weight? The weight of a body is the force with which the earth attracts. Or in other words, you can say weight of a body is the force of gravity on it. If we are talking about, we are saying about force, so it means its SI unit is Newton. CGS unit is dyne. What is the relation between Newton and dyne? 1 Newton is equal to 10 ki power 5 dyne. And what is the relation between mass and weight? This formula has come. W is equal to m into g, where W is the weight, m is the mass, and g is the acceleration due to gravity. Now we can say, what is the difference between a mass and a weight? See, mass is a scalar quantity, but weight is a vector quantity. Mass can be measured by physical balance or beam balance, but weight can be measured by spring balance. Mass, it is constant for a body. Mass is constant for a body and it does not change with the change in place. But weight, it is not constant for a body. It varies from place to place due to the change in the value of acceleration due to gravity. Now children, we are having other units of gravitational force. Gravitational units of force are, in MKS system, its unit is kilogram force. Kilogram force, see the symbol kgf. And in CGS system, its unit is gram force. See the symbol, children, its symbol is gf. And what is the relation? Relation, 1 kgf is equal to 9.8 newton, and 1 gf is equal to 989. Children, this relation you have to learn, and they will help us in doing the numerical. Now what you can say, what is 1 kilogram force? 1 kilogram force is the force due to gravity on a mass of 1 kg. And here also, what is 1 gram force? 1 gram force is the force due to gravity on a mass of 1 gram. And this is the relation. So from this relation, we can say that if 1 kgf is equal to 9.8 newton, so we means that if we have to exert a force of 9.8 newton to hold a mass of 1 kg on our palm. Now children, we have finished the explanation of this chapter. Now I am giving you the assignment. This is your assignment of exercise 3E. Children, first you have to do 6 question, then 7 question, then 8 question, 11, 12 14 17 18 19 22. These questions you have to do it in your physics register. Thank you, children.